Greetings! Welcome to my Honoka Guide Tutorial. I'm Force of Nature representing top tier tips, and I welcome you to your prime spot for tips and tricks to help you level up at Dead or Alive 5. Alright, in this session, we're gonna be going all kawaii. That's right, we're looking at the salad chick herself, Honoka, and we're just gonna see what she's made of. Well, which is salad. Anyways, from what I kind of mean why she ends up getting dubbed that is Honoka's gameplay is kind of based around an amalgamation of moves from various characters, leading to her kind of being dubbed the salad, which is just kind of just a little help, a little serving, a little helping of everything. Alright, as for strengths with Honoka, her strengths involve, well, for starters, her fast speed and her relative overall versatility of her moveset, basically just a huge variety of tools that she has to gets to work with, which can be which is both a strength of her but also a kind of challenge for utilizing her, because she just has a lot of just different kind of moves and tools that you have to get used to using and implementing, which also in general is a challenge with a difficulty and a challenge with 3D fighters in general, is just knowing how to use her tools. So yeah, with Honoka, that is one of the more challenging and intricate part of her gameplay, is like how you apply her tools in particular. Another strength she also has is she also does have, she actually has particularly fast walking speed, especially like walking forward, so that can be like really good like during the footsie game and stuff like that. Anyways, before you really like go on and like do anything else with Honoka, I definitely recommend checking out her both her command training and combo challenge. Just really just get used to like how her flow is. Like her flow can be a little weird. So I'll give you a little hint now that she has quite a bit of in the way of kind of having to utilize stances. And a weird quirk with her is that she can't transition into the stances if the lead-in move gets blocked, so that is something to keep in mind. Anyways, let's go on to it. Ah, jeez, he stops. Alright, here we are in the command training. As you can see right at the top, Honoka has about 112 moves. I did mention, I think a little earlier, that yeah, she does have a pretty big moveset. 112 is considered above average. There are characters in the cast such as like Brad Wong or like Ayane and I think Kasumi for example that physically have more moves than that, but that's just because of moves out of stances. But for like Honoka, this is almost a lot, majority of these tools is just like, I mean moves is just kind of just the sheer amount of like tools that she kind of has like available to her. So I mean, when you're just like getting used to her command training, the general moves that you probably do want to kind of look out for is anything that goes to a stance. So right there, that one goes into one of Brad Wong's stances. I forget what it is. I just call it the crane stance. I think it's abbreviated to DHO. So it also, I mean, can also come out of like her 3K. So that is one of her like main stances. Other ones she has is like Helena's Bokuho. There's also some other ones that could go into like Jan Li's dragon stance. So yeah, there's quite a bit of spins. There's another one, Zach's duck in stance. So there you can go into Christie's rolling stance. So as you could probably tell, I can like keep going with this. So, but yeah, the main thing with the command training for Honoka is just getting used to like the sheer amount of different like variety of like moves and like stances and things that she can like end up doing with her tools. Oh, by the way, this move is also gonna drive you nuts. Oh, I hate doing that move. It looks really badass when you get it, but the input's such a pain in the ass. For 2 people scale 4-6 P, what you actually have to do is you have to try and like just frame the last move just like that. It's a really tough thing to do, but when you can end up getting off, then yeah, and you can finish off some of Honoka's combos with a lot of swag. Anyways, let's moving along to her close range game. Alright, here we go. Now I'm going to be going over Honoka's close range game right now. Alright, right at the beginning in terms of strengths, I said that one of Honoka's strengths is that she has some of the fastest pokes in the game. So I can do like a little like recap there. I think I did go over some of them. Alright, I'll just let you know she has a 9 frame jab, 11 frame 6 feet, 12 frame 6K, and 13 frame 2P. So you can just check it for yourself right here with the move details. Kind of really nice having a 12 frame 6K because very few characters really have that. I mean, the only ones that I know of that have one that's like not a poke would be, and can also do it from neutral, like, well, this is Zack's 6K. I think Naotora also has one. Rick has one, but it's a launcher, so I mean, there's not really that many 12 frame mid kicks, and the fact that Honoka has one that it can use as a poke is like really, that's actually like really handy. So when you're in close, Honoka gets buttons. But also, I also did allude to a bit of a hint that for certain moves that can transition on, like this is like a Kokoro's Heishu stance attacker 660 plus K. This one can transition, but if it gets blocked, that's all you get is that move, and then I'm left at minus 8, which it will allow me to be throw punishable. So you have to be careful with moves that end up transitioning to stances if you're not certain that the move is going to end up connecting on the opponent. Like if you're unable to be able to fully like hit confirm it or anything like that. So as you can guess, it's risky to use these moves like from neutral unless you're like pretty much certain it's going to hit. So it's best that when during a neutral game when you're poking, it's best to stick to moves that don't have to worry about like transitioning into block. But a little neat thing to remember is, as you can see right here, like Zack's ducking stance can transition into block. That's a move that's generally recommended more so for mid-range, but it is one of Honoka's good pokes in general. Right, on an opponent, feel free to drop some keys on their block or if it connects or anything, because Honoka does get a solid guard break at the end of her P string with PPPK right there, so he gets a plus one off of a fast string. Off of her P string, she also has an elbow. I showed you earlier she can go into the dragon stance. Has Jan Lee's kind of what's up move it right there. She can do a PP 2K. Right here is a little low you can use. Little warning that this move can be good for mix-up purposes, but if you end up doing it predictably, or if you end up just telegraphing the move, then the opponent can elbow you, or they can elbow you for free, or they can, if they're quick, they can like try and low hold it. But yeah, if you keep abusing that, then the opponent will eventually just elbow you for free. So that's why you have to. You have to kind of mix up different variations of that, but yeah, I like Honoka's, I like her P strings though. I mean, quite a bit of options out of it. On an opponent's, it's also like PK too. On an opponent's block, I also don't mind 6K that much. A lot of times though, you're just gonna, oh, not that. A lot of times you're just gonna be doing, just a 6K. But the thing about it though is it has a fast load just like Zack. So this is a 6K, 2K. You also have 6KK. So you have both a low option and a mid option. The downside to that is that both options are unsafe on block. So that means you can get fully throw punished if either ender gets blocked. See, there it is possible to delay the follow-up, so that's a way to kind of trip the opponent up. But if you don't really use this move too predictably, then you can catch opponents off guard with a 6K, 2K, so yeah, feel free to implement that move into your playstyle. And you see, you end up getting a free knockdown also to set up like a force tech. Alright, other moves to poke with is Honoka 6B. As you can see, it's nothing really special on normal hits, but if you were to connect it on counter hit, yeah, plus 26 for a really fast 11 frame elbow. It's right there, so as you can guess with Honoka, a good way to start our offense is trying to fish for that counter hit. The counter hit elbow. It's right there, 6P and 6K. 6K is also decent on him. Counter hit, but oh man. Love these juicy nosebleed stunts you get from this. Like, I know a lot of 6Ps, a lot of elbows can do that, but when you have an 11 frame move like that, this is, as you can guess, this is a pretty important tool for Honoka. I will also give you the little warnings. Be careful of kind of your little T-Rex arm, so yeah. You can still be pretty close to the opponent and still whip, so you have to be careful of that. Like, with their move details here, you can check the move ranges, and Hanukkah's are pretty damn bad. I mean, like, a lot of her moves don't really go very far at all. I mean, she has stuff like 4K, which is good, but in general, I mean, her moves don't really go that far. I mean, a lot of her fast pokes, like, barely go over 1.5. Don't even really go over like 1.3 meters, so that is something to be careful of. I mean, like someone like Christy also has an 11 frame 6P and it goes like 1.76, 1.78 meters or something like that. So yeah, with Honoka, she's kind of, yeah, she's a little like vertically challenged in that way, or horizontally challenged, whatever you want to call it. So yeah, you have to mind your range with Honoka. To help you augment that, as I alluded to a bit earlier, like during footsies, Honoka's movement speed is really good. I mean, it's not necessarily immediately noticeable, but if you like do compare it with the different characters, then you can see, especially when she's walking forward, that she does walk forward really fast. So her walk speed is really, really nice during footsies. But of course, because of Honoka's lack of because of her lack of range in general, you are gonna have to be a little extra patient during the neutral game. So that is something to keep in mind. So I mean, like, so have a little fun with her, just getting used to her flow of her walk. So I mean, not many characters you have to pay attention to that as extra as important as with Honoka. All right, just continuing on with pokes. Alright, I did recommend different things off of her P strings, even just doing a little PP, and of course, always remembering your guard break. So you can use her P strings, or like 6P strings, like 6PP, I think is minus 7 on block, so it's semi safe. Her 6K strings, you get the low off that. If you're in close, you can also just 2P. Well, that's counter hit, you can also 2P. I think it's just neutral, but it's a 13 frame 2P, and neutral's perfectly fine if you have a 11 frame elbow and a 9 frame jab. So neutrals, I mean, it's really good. If you want to try and get frisky and close, you could try maybe fish for a counter hit with like her 9PP strings and stuff like that. It's one of Brad Wong's moves. So yeah, that's another thing you can try, although I usually recommend her jab strings, but you could still occasionally throw an opponent off with her 9P strings. All right, as for high crushing lows to use with Honoka, I would recommend, well, of course there's 2P, there's 1P, and 1K. If you want, and your opponent is kind of, I don't know, they're a little overly defensive and flustered, you can try and sneak in 2H plus K. Like, this move is I could show at a plus 1 guard break. So So I mean, this one does have both jumping and crouching capabilities. As you can guess, this move is slower than the other options. Like 1P is a okay option. Like, I mean, it's at 18 frames, it's not really reactable. But as you can see, it is negative on normal hits. So any option you do after that, this could be some sort of a barre, whether it's a jab or elbow. So you have to be careful with that. That opponents, I mean, it's the same as Genfu's 1P, which is also minus 3. So a lot of opponents will try and poke back. So as you can guess, this is good as a round ender or just sneaking in a low poke. So 1P is handy, and it is does reach pretty far, like over 1.73 meters, which is like, wow, that is far for Honoka. So this move is just as godlike with Honoka as it is with Genfu. Other high crush moves, so 3PPP, pretty much the exact same move as Christie, although you can't charge it in any way with Honoka. You get up to 3 punches, then on the third one, she just goes to the machine gun fists. It is safe on block at minus 5, so you can occasionally chuck it out. If you want like a high crush launcher, you have Brad Wong's 3-3P. See, it can launch on counter hit. This right here actually probably will be your go-to launcher on counter hit. And if you want to be really disrespectful and want to try and induce some rage in your opponents, Honoka does have Lei Fang's the shoulder. It still has pretty pitiful range, but it really, when you have a move that just kind of beats out like almost everything, why not, right? Let's chuck it out. So this is Honoka's disrespect. Whoa, wow, whiffs even that close. Ah, man. She wouldn't be complete without the shoulder, would she? So yeah, she has the shoulder, but it's 4P plus K for her, not 3P plus K as it is with Lei Fang, so don't forget to keep that in mind. For opponents that are overly defensive, probably one of Honoka's best tools for opening someone up is 6T, free hugs. Every time you do the bear hug, you get plus 9. Like I know when the... If I remember the source character for it ended up getting maybe a bit more, but for Honoka right there, with plus 9, it basically means you can do like almost any poke after it. It doesn't push back too far, which is nice, so you can kind of keep doing it if you want to. Until the opponent gets tired of hugging, then you can end up like, if they actually like try and beat you out, well, there, as you see it at a wall, you get a slump stun, which disables wake up fix, which is pretty good. But in open space, opponents eventually gonna get tired of doing that. Then you can end up, you can blast them back with that, or you can elbow them. So free hugs is this is another one of Honoka's best tools, along with her 6P, and of course, I mean, who doesn't love getting hugged though? I mean, like, come on, Honoka, bring in the love. All right, now I'm gonna be going on to low crush moves. Easily my favorite low crush move with Honoka is good old 3H plus K. Very similar to Hitomi. Unfortunately, Honoka is a little shorter than Hitomi, so I don't know if the range is as good, but really, Honoka gets a really, really nice trade-off. I mean, look at this. This move, I mean, if I do it in point-blank range, it's minus 4, so you're fully safe from throw punishment. If you do it out a bit, you see, you can manipulate the frames a bit, so now what happens is the disadvantage goes down the further out you use it. See, if you can get it at complete tip range, you're only minus 1, which is barely anything. Generally, the range you're going to be doing this move at the most, unless you're really predicting the low and close and doing point blank range, is the range where it'll be around minus 2 on block. So it's around the tip of close and mid range. So I mean, so if you wanted to, sometimes you can just, if you have to move the opponent on the defensive, you can usually chuck this out for almost like no consequence at all. So I mean, a 3H stay is a really good move. Other low crushes you can try is see. Yeah, she has it's another move from Hitomi. For Honoka, it's her 9K. See, safe on block, crushes lows really well. You can also use 4H plus K. Same speed as 3H plus K, but it's a plus 3 guard break. Or plus 2, like it varies based on range, of course. Like as you could probably guess, the further out you hit something, the less disadvantage you get, because it's only a few of the frames connecting on the opponent's block, so right there. Fortunately, it's plus 3, you can't do anything with it, but you generally can, well, obviously act before your opponent, so if you want a little guard break, you can try 4H plus K, but I generally like how 3H plus K, how it grounds the opponent and you can get a free ground hit or something. Alright, when it comes to guard breaks with Honoka, I mean, she has a crap load. I mean, wow, if I were to list off every single one right here, we could be here for quite a while. I mean, I can't actually show you like some of them, and I might actually go over most of them. I mean, she even has a couple like good frame advantage moves too, but I could say a few others, like kind of notable guard breaks. Like her 7P gives her plus 13. Her 236 H plus K gives her plus 23. Her 236 P plus K gives her plus 11. So those are some of the biggest ones. Also 4 PPP, where you hold the last P, you get Well, you can get up to about like plus 20, depending on range. But in general, it usually gives you plus 19. With Honoka, generally any guard brick that would give you like at least plus 13 will give you can give you like a free elbow, since your elbow is 11 frames. And basically, the way how the activation works is for any advantage that is plus 13 or higher, 11 frame moves become guaranteed. In general, 7P only gives you something for free if done in a corner. Right now, there's like a little invisible wall right here. If I do it further out, fortunately, it won't reach. So in a corner, you can use this for corner pressure and get a free corner combo. As for like something like 236 H plus K, you get a free booty bump. Oh man, I botched that. Anyway, so yeah, you can you can basically get a free booty bump mix up if you do. If you end up doing 236 K on an opponent's block, so free booty bump, booty. I'll go over a few more guard breaks now. I don't know if necessarily if I'll go over all of them, but other ones that you can use is her 66K M6. This is Lisa's move here. If you go into the Carrera stance, which is just the running stance, you get plus 6, so a plus 6 mix-up. If you don't go into Carrera, then you're conversely left at minus 6, which actually isn't really that bad, so it's a fully safe move, so the opponents will generally gonna expect you to go into that stance, so I don't know if they're really gonna take advantage of you not going into it, unless that's all you do is not go into the stance. You also have Hitomi's P plus K PP, so you get plus 3. There's actually a good one I like here. It's only neutral, but either running P or 4-6 P, so you get a neutral guard break. But you can't use it for pressure, because if the opponent is stunned or anything like that, you see you can knock him off the wall with that. It even gives you a close hit. So look at that. So that's if you do it right in the opponent's face, you get You get 52 damage. I mean, yeah, it's a 20 frame move, so the opponent has to be on the defensive or really careless to really get hit by that in neutral, but if the opponent's like stunned, for instance, then you can use it for a wall slam. But of course, during stun, you won't get the close hit property, but basically the point of this though is, if you have a little bit of an advantage, it's a move that you can throw out where whether it blocks or gets hit is fine for Honoka. I also showed you some of the other guard breaks. 4H plus K, 2H plus K, so you get either plus 2 or plus 1. Another interesting guard break is Tina's ass move, the big butt move. If you end up doing it and you end up landing in close, it'll be minus 2. If you can somehow get it at tip range, you can be up to like at least like plus 2. I don't know if you can go higher, but right there I got plus 1 from the range that I was at. So something like that can be used as like an occasional kind of get in move. So there's another guard break. As for a couple other frame advantage moves, of course, before I go on, I already showed you that guard break quite a bit, the PPPK. 236, P plus K gives you plus 1, and 4K2 gives you plus 2. Oh, wow. We've gone over a lot of guard breaks, and if I can get it. So you see right there that the guard break off of the 2P plus K, 4-6P just frame move. It now gives Honoka plus 1. It's the same for Elliot too. I mean, well, Elliot gets a different advantage off of his, but it basically, before that move actually got buffed in a relatively recent patch, it used to actually be like, I mean, slightly negative on block, like minus 2 or minus 3 around there. So this move being positive is actually really nice. As for a recap for guard breaks, I'll just remind you, if you end up pressuring with an opponent in a corner with 7P, you get a free 6P, so you can do either 6PP or, well, if you're close enough, 6PK. Both those options can guard break because the opponent can technically hold the second hit, so just simply randomly do this. Just 6PK is probably more recommended simply because some people that will default to trying to hold the 6PP. So yeah, so that's really neat though. In 7P, 30 frames, it's not too slow. 236K, whether you're at a wall or an open space, generally I do recommend booty bump, like I said earlier. Other things also to keep in mind is her power blow gives her, I think, about plus 15. Same thing, free 6P. If I'm not mistaken, careful for range and open space. Yeah, her elbow doesn't really connect that well, so in open space, you don't really get as much off of her power blow. Like most people with their power blow, when it's fully charged, can get a free elbow, like a free guard break move. But unfortunately with Honoka, it's only really good in corners. So yeah, you have to be careful with that. Also with the 236 P plus K airwalk move, it does go into duck and stance, although unfortunately the fall up at plus 11, the fall up's not guaranteed, but that is still a lot of advantage though. So but anyways, that's a lot of good, it's still like a lot of good variety with ways to how to pressure the opponent or how to kind of work in different guard breaks with Honoka, which is actually like kind of neat though. Like I said, she just has like a crap load of tools to work with. I almost missed one. If you get 4 PPP, get a free launcher, which is actually pretty cool. Alright, moving on to Honoka's mid-range to long-range game now. I'll just end up combining the two because I'll just say right off the bat, really don't bother trying to play Honoka as a ranged character because she's just simply not designed for it. I mean, her little stubby limb syndrome is gonna really, can really bite you in the ass if you try and play Honoka as like kind of like a zoning character or anything like that. So yeah. Basically, your goal with Honoka is just to try and hover around kind of mid to, well, the outside of close, the edge of like close range, so the tip between close and like mid range. With Honoka, that's a decent place to hang around. So I mean, with their good movement, you can end up going in and out pretty well. So yeah, I mean, like I said earlier, as long as you're patient with your movement, then you can get to a range that you feel comfortable with her. But if you just really do have to end up fighting at mid range, or if your opponent is trying to zone you out, or is zoning you out, some moves you can use to poke with Honoka is, I really really like her 4K. Like I might have showed you some like stats on this move earlier. I mean, it's 17 frame move. Only look at that, -1 on block, and it has a stance which actually makes it an advantage. So 4K though, I mean, really good mid range poke. You can use it as a little bit of a get in move if you want to, because with Hitomi can actually be low throw punish for her version of this, but I mean, like Honoka, yeah, see right there, you're in your opponent's face, only -2, so if you want to be a bit of a dick to them, try and punch them in the face and see if you can Abari something. But really though, I mean, you can't get punished at all just for chucking this move out. So that's another one you can try though. Of course, I really prefer that. You could try and use Kokoro's the 6-6 P+K to Heishu move, but I just don't really like how it doesn't transition on block. And -8 means you could be thrown by a 7 frame throw, which is a guaranteed throw punishment. So it's safer to do this, or other moves you can like use to get in is like Lisa's 6-6K. Oh no, I like that move because it's spammable. Oh, unfortunately with Honoka, she can't loop it like Lisa does. She gets a different she gets a different guard break. Oh, to end up complimenting 4K, actually, there's another move that I also kind of like. For Honoka, it's H+K, but Hitomi is the same move. It's very similar to like 4K. They're both similar speeds. So this one's H+K is 18 frames, but look at this. It's only -2. The only difference is Honoka does not get Hitomi's follow-ups, but really -2, it doesn't really matter. This serves a similar purpose to 4K, except for H+K is mainly the catch tracking, so. So you get a stun on normal hit. So if you catch the opponent stepping, you just hit him with this move, and yeah, wall slams too. Other get-in moves I do like is, I don't really mind her running moves like running P, 4-6P. Be a little careful with the speed when using it during neutral. But if the opponent is hanging back, then you can try and sneak it in. Don't mind running P+K. Just like any move that's really either safe or advantage in block is usually okay, as long as you don't use it in really predictable fashions. Because as you see, Honoka has quite a bit of moves that are like fairly safe. A lot of Hanukkah's unsafety tends to come from, it's like doing moves that transition into a, doing moves that usually would transition to a stance, or even a move that does transition into a stance can still be like negative. Like right here is going into the crane stance. So basically with Honoka, I definitely recommend just honestly just try and play as safe as you can with her, and that's usually a good approach to take with her. And if you want to be godlike online, then just use, if you nail an opponent with this regularly, then yes, that's what it is. According to the Baymin master himself, Dragon Kid, the ultimate poke. So yeah, with Honoka, it's just as much as a, it's either just a swag or as much a liability as when Danley does it. The difference is, remember, of course, Honoka has shorter legs, so she doesn't go as far. Yeah, I mean, gotta be some sort of drawbacks, but other than that though, I mean, it is pretty much one of her longest range moves. I mean, along with running P+K, but the main thing about this move is that the sole point of this move is just to be an unblockable that move that exists. I mean, yeah, if you do it from neutral, the opponent's just gonna duck and blow you up, but of course you feel like a complete badass when it actually hits, so... So yeah, use that move with a lot, a high degree of discretion, or just to be a dick like I said earlier. Yeah, there's also other running moves, like she has Damon's running H plus K. Just all these moves by them, like a move like this can also be like the dragon kick. I mean, the dragon kick I showed earlier. It can be a gimmick, but of course, when you have multiple options, then yeah, your gimmick can turn into a bit of a mix-up. So if you can mix these up well, you can eventually sneak them in. On the other hand, by themselves, they are kind of reactable. So right there, so running H plus K is another option you can do to try sneaking like a low poke on an opponent. All right, we're taking things to the gym now. We're going to be taking a look at Honoka's hero game. Overall, I'd say for being a speedy kind of striker based, somewhat pressure based character, her throw game is actually pretty decent. She unfortunately doesn't really have any like offensive holds, I don't think, or anything like that. But of course, your go-to throw, her 7th frame, 16. Free hug. One of the best things you can do with Honoka on your opponent is hug them. Besides demoralizing them, she gets a nice juicy plus 9. So basically, the strategy with Honoka in close is to find a way to get the opponent to get hugged, and you just keep, and when you suspect they're tired of hugging them, then just elbow them. Because as I showed you earlier, see, counter hit elbows are really good. You can mix it up with counter hit knees also. I mean, like, remember, like, plus 9, you can even use, like, an 18 frame move, and he should beat out, like, almost anything the opponent will do. I mean, it might be a little iffy with, if you're going up against a 9 frame jab, but under most circumstances, you can also do, an H plus K. Like, it's a similar strategy, like, for instance, with, like, Hitomi's own 60. So if you suspect they're gonna try and sidestep, then you just give them a little good H plus K. If you want to try and sneak a low poke, then just do, like, 6K, 2K. Be careful of the second hit being reactable, but that's just kind of the main idea of getting used to mixing in different things with that throw. Alright, her 4T, her 10 frame throw is just simply used for switching sides. Unfortunately for Honoka's throws, the damage is actually kind of average. Right here, you do it again, 3-3T, Ayn's badass throw. Alright, Honoka just gets 62 damage, which is quite respectable. If you end up doing it to an opponent at a wall, like how 60 is a wall version, Honoka also gets a badass wall version with 3-3-T, just like Ayn, just pummels the crap out of the opponent, so yeah, that's pretty good. Oh yeah, also let you know that she also does have a running throw. Oh wow, I just whipped it. Best running throw in the game, Tina's Shining Wizard. And if you do it from too close, and I end up just getting a hug, but there we go, kick to the face. She also has two more throws from her Hizatsu no Kamai stance. Man, I might have botched saying that, but basically I just end up calling it the HNK for short. So that's the kind of special stance here. I end up how do I go into it? Oh, I know, if you just press B here, that second stance right there would be it, so you can do the throw, but unfortunately the main point of the throw is to punish with holds. Like I also said earlier, 3-3-T, 12 frame throw, so that's also used to punish with holds, but lots of times the opponent's gonna think you're going for that burst move, so instead, then you can go for a throw. Here, let me show you it. When the throw actually does connect the opponent, because the two throws from there actually do look pretty cool. Yeah, There, it's a really awesome, it's a really awesome jump and throw. That's Raidu's, I think it's called the Underworld Drop. So yeah, it is pretty awesome. Here, let me show you the other one. Yeah, so a couple pretty awesome throws that Honoka has there that she naturally inherited from Raidu, who may or may not be her daddy. And so yeah, so you have a couple moves there to keep opponents from wanting to hold out of her H and K stance. As for Honoka's wall game, basically the number one move I recommend to wall slam an opponent with is Death Fist. 236p. Let me get that off right now. So yeah, it's number one move for slamming the opponent with. Other moves you can use is 6pp, 6pk, H plus K, 46p. As for like counter hit moves or during stun, use K, and 4k are a couple good options. If you do end up wall slamming the opponent, I recommend doing 33p, 33p, then 3pppp. Sometimes you can also try. Let me get this. You can also try 4pppp. You have the ability to kind of charge a little bit at the end. Although, yes, it can drop a bit more easily, and you only get like a couple more points of damage. So 3 is usually the best one that I recommend. All right. So, anyways, here I'm just gonna show you a little critical burst juggle with Honoka. All right. So let her just get into fighting form now. All right, in that juggle, what I ended up doing was the 3K, then 4K into P plus KP, then you go for the little burst move, then after the launcher, I did 33K, H plus K, K, 6K, then the 2P plus K, oh wow, then the 2P plus K, 4-6P just frame move, and right there you get you get pretty good damage. Anyways, that is it for now. Alright, so things to practice with Honoka. What I would recommend is basically just learning how to flow through her stances. I mean, like there I showed an example, like off of 3K, you can do the 4K, then you have to immediately on hit, you have to press P plus K to go into the rolling stance. So, or also remember like Kokoro's Keishu stance of 660 plus K. Just remembering to end up using the right option, either the P option, the K option, or the P plus K option, for example. So just learning to be able to transition the stance. Because you have to remember, a big thing is that you can't transition on an opponent's block. So you basically have to confirm it. And when you confirm the hit, you have to know what you want to end up doing out of said stance. And of course, the other thing to practice with her for sure is definitely her 2P plus K, 4-6P. So, I mean, come on, you gotta make sure that you end up having just as much fun as I had trying to learn how to do that move. Just even when you think you get it down, you'll end up slipping up and end up getting that silly Genku headbutt instead. But, so that is actually, in my opinion, probably one of the harder, if, well, I don't know if it's necessarily the hardest, but one of the harder moves of the main DOA cast to end up perform. I know that some of the VF characters in this game can have some harder moves, like, oh man, like Akira's just for me, but other than that, though, of the DOA characters, it is one of the harder moves. Alright, before I end up going, I will give you also a little couple tidbits that Honoka does have to unblockable moves. I already showed you one of them, the ultimate poke, the dragon kick, and she also has fast's mid guard break. I mean, unblockable, so she has both a high unblockable and mid unblockable, which is this half circle back P plus K, then press P plus K again, then you end up getting the unblockable move. So, yeah, I mean, I don't know how many other characters have two unblockable moves, one high and one mid. And also, she has like 7 close hit moves. So remember, close hit move. When you see that, when you do a certain move in close range, you end up getting the close hit modifier. Honoka has at least 7 of them. So have fun trying to like figure them out and anything like that. All right. If you have any questions about anything related to this guide or just DOA or Honoka in general, then feel free to message me on freestepdodge.com as Force of Nature. You can also contact me on my YouTube, Twitter, or Twitch. All right. I also do want to give a shout out to Mikotsumi for helping me out with learning Honoka. It gave me some really cool tips related to her. So yeah, you can check out his Honoka also. And also be sure to check out my other character guides just to get a more like well-rounded look at the cast. Has your favorite been done yet? If not, recommend them down in the comments. Like, more than half the cast has been done, so yeah. And if I do get up to around maybe 500 subs, then a certain super ninja may be ready. Well, anyways, that's it for now. Thanks for tuning in, and I'll see you next time on Top Tier Tips.